Hey there, what's up you guys? It's me, your boy JD, and welcome back to the channel. And for today's episode, what we are going to be talking about is the Harden Step Back 2. So alright, before we begin, I'd like to invite you guys to please do subscribe to the channel and click the notification bell so that you guys can stay updated for these kinds of uploads, you know, the budget deals all over the internet, and of course budget shoe performance reviews. And with that, let's start talking about the traction. So as you guys can see on the clip, the traction pattern is very similar to how the Harden Volume 5 actually looks like. The only difference is that they place the three stripes there instead of saying boost, and you've got this traction pattern that actually gives me the 90s internet web kind of vibe, kind of gives me that feel. So when Nike mentioned that the Kyrie 7 was the data-driven pattern, and then I saw this, I was just like, no, this is the data-driven kind of traction pattern, because it looks like it came out of a computer. It looks like it came out of a printer or something. So good, getting you through niya sumu atalagasyon galing sa printer. And I feel like it's gonna perform very well, and the reason for that is upon initial wearing, as you guys can see on the clip, it does feel a little bit grippy here on my room, and I feel like it's gonna be able to grip, especially on a dusty court, especially with this kind of color. And you know, when you do this, you can actually feel how grippy the rubber compound is. The only problem that I do have is that when it comes to the toe area or the forefoot area right here, is that the durability seems to be a little bit problematic. But when it comes to the heel area, where the spaces in between the grooves become bigger, the rubber compound seems to be more durable. So in terms of durability, I think it will vary pretty much depending on where you play and how you play. Now moving up to the cushion setup, this is where I think the shoe wins over the mainline, which is the Harden Volume 5. And it has this full-length bounce, doesn't have any caging. And the reason for it being better is I just don't understand what they did with the Volume 5s, man. I don't understand. I mean, you already went with boost drop in midsole. You already integrated light strike. And I don't have any idea how you can mess that up. And then you've got the Step Back 2s, which has full-length bounce, and at the same time, it's not caged. It has a minimal setup, and upon initial wearing, the stepping comfort is already great in itself. It's way better than the Step Back 1s, because the Step Back 1s had really thin bounce cushion setup. But this one, I feel like it's gonna be well balanced. I feel like it's something that I'm gonna enjoy, especially on how low profile that bounce setup is. But again, we still need to, you know, do a performance run on these guys before we can actually say that the cushion setup is actually good. Now moving up to the materials, this is where the shoe actually makes a lot of noise. So it's pretty much textile all over the place. The orange thing, the shoe itself, it's pretty much textile. And then you've got a plastic heel counter, this blue right here. And then, you know, you've got synthetics all over the place, and even here on the lace area right here. And then you've got this leather panel right here, this teal kind of color, and that acts as a wing for containment on your laces. And it does remind me a little bit of, I don't know if you guys ever had one of those, yung keychain na parang leather. Yeah, you know, the ones that your parents use. That one, it does remind me a lot of that. So, but then again, I think being a synthetic kind of material, and it has that metal loop right there, or eyelet, or whatever you guys call that, for the lacing, I feel like it's gonna help a lot with the containment. And speaking of containment, let's go to the fit support and the lockdown. So for the fit, my suggestion is probably go down half a size, but then that's just for me, that's the mid-arc kind of person. And the reason for that is, in terms of length, this is a size 8. It's good lengthwise, and it does have a snug fit right here. But in terms of the width, it's pretty much good. But in terms of the upper right here, that's where the snug fit comes along. So my suggestion would be, if you want a little bit of a looser fit, or if you want a one-to-one fit, my suggestion would just be go true to size, because my true to size is actually 8.5. But if you want a snug fit, you can go down half a size. But if you want somewhere of a loose fit, you can go up half a size. So my suggestion, again guys, my suggestion is, if you really like a snug fit, you can go down half a size in this, especially if you're a mid-arc kind of person, you're not really narrow footed, or you're not really a wide footer. But again, if you are a wide footer, my suggestion would be go up half a size. All right so now moving on to the support and the lockdown. So for the support, you've got this outrigger that's here, that's very nice. It's not as huge as you'd want it to be, and pretty much stable, so you won't roll your ankles. The first layer right here is separated from this one, and then when you yank on the laces, you'll feel very contained within the sneaker, so that's good as well. You also have two heel counters. You've got an internal and an external heel counter, which is very great, so that you really feel secure within the sneaker. And then now for the lockdown, all you guys gotta do is yank on the laces. And with this leather panel right here, you're pretty much secured within the sneaker. And these three stripes right here will act as a lateral containment system as well. So you've got a good. And then, like what I mentioned, it is a two-layer kind of system. As you guys can see here on the medial side, this is pretty much the first layer of the sneaker. And then you've got that stitched on, which is goes all the way up to here. So it has a lot of layers for support. So that's very good. And then we'll just wait on the performance review on how it actually performs. Now going on to the aesthetics, this is actually a very nice shoe for me. Honestly speaking, the one that I wanted is that colorway, the black and white colorway, because Harden is already in the Brooklyn Nets. But this one though, this one is very, very noisy. Actually, I like all the colors of the step back twos. The Chinese New Year one looks great. Even the triple black looks great. Actually, almost all the colorways, because they're very funky. It looks very, very nice, guys. So yeah, I actually like it. I can't wait to go ahead and try it out. I have a lot of Adidas shoes to do performance reviews on. So anyways, guys, that pretty much takes care of it for our initial impressions on the Harden Step Back 2s. If you guys are interested in copying a pair, I'll be leaving links down in the description box so you guys can just check them all out depending on your budget and depending on the deal that you would want. So if you guys like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button and of course, subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so that you guys can stay updated for budget deals, budget finds, and of course, budget shoe performance reviews here on the channel. And of course, don't forget to follow us on Instagram, like us on Facebook, follow us on Spotify and on TikTok. And of course, guys, that pretty much takes care of it. Don't forget to get registered so that you guys can actually get vaccinated. Anyways, guys, this was your boy JD, and I'll see you guys on the next episode.